Welcome to the graduating class of 2020. You have made it. We are so thrilled to celebrate with you today.
Congratulations, everyone. We're so happy that you could join us today. And first, we just want to start with a thank you to Walgreens for their support in helping make this event possible. Throughout the event, we encourage you to use the hashtag GirlUpGrad and post about Girl Up graduation. Girl Up is also now on TikTok, as you've heard, and you can check out Walgreens graduation TikTok challenge and be sure to use the tags hashtag GradJump, hashtag PromPremix, and tag Walgreens as well.
Not every graduating class gets to say they celebrated with their peers from all over the globe. Let us know where you're from in the chat.
Definitely a special graduation to be able to connect with all of the Girl Up clubs. We'd love to hear from all of you and where you're from, so go ahead and drop your name and where you're from. For those of you who don't know, my name is Morgan, and I'm currently in New York.
And I'm Lisa, and I'm currently in Colorado. So, hey, Michigan and Maryland, and I see you, Mexico, North Macedonia. Awesome. New York, not far from Morgan. Truly a global graduation. Germany, I see you.
Maryland. We're so happy you can all join us today.
So you all are graduating. Sorry,
Lisa. So many of you are celebrating tonight with us, and we want you to let us know how you're celebrating. So there will be a poll that pops up in the group as well. So that should be popping up for you, and you can share more information with us about where you're from, maybe what year you're graduating from. Thank you all.
Well, no matter what you're celebrating today, we are so proud of you. You all are graduating during a pivotal moment in the United States and around the globe, where the world has loudly declared that Black Lives Matter. This is the result of centuries of racial injustice against the Black community. And as the world rises to the occasion of the fight for justice, we must continue to follow the leadership of the Black community. And we know that justice begins within our own hearts and homes. We want more justice so there will be more peace. Please join us in a moment of silence for the lives of George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, Ahmaud Arbery, and Tony McDade, and the story of those known and unknown who have passed away as the result of systemic oppression, and in recognition of the centuries of freedom fighters who have laid the work for this moment.
Thank you, everyone. We know that Girl Up clubs are involved and are supporting the Black Lives Matter movement. And these are just a few of the many organizations out there doing great work that you can look to and keep you informed and supported while supporting Black Lives Matter. We will be sharing this with the Girl Up community this afternoon as well, so you'll be able to access these resources.
Activism, advocacy, and being a leader of self requires an inner resilience you've already proven you have as the class of 2020. We hope this lineup of true pace setters from the UN Secretary General's Envoy on Youth, our Girl Up Teen Advisor, and the Girl Up Executive Director will inspire you to continue this work as you graduate and build your future. First up, we have a very special guest and longtime Girl Up champion and champion of young people committed to building a world better than the one they inherited, Miss Monique Coleman.
Woo! I'm so delighted to be here with everyone today. This is a very unique but beautiful experience. And it's wonderful that we're all able to be together from all over the world. So thank you so much for having me in this moment. I spent most of my youth waiting for my life to begin, expecting that there would be some iconic landmark moments that validated my place in the world. Moments like this, graduating, meeting my person, overcoming obstacles. These are all achievements that we believe that we can hang our hats on. And right now, this graduating class is launching into a world that we've never seen before. And my message to you is that you're ready. Your life has already begun, and you have everything that you need to be who you're meant to be. For the last 10 years, I've watched girls learn the skills and habits of leadership. We've passed the Girls Count Act, fought to end child marriage, prioritize education, health, and the advancement of girls to have uplifted millions of girls all over the world. I mean, we've even gotten to meet Michelle Obama. I've watched you form deep connections with your sisters all over the world. I've seen you find your voices and step into your power. And as you've done this, I've done this right alongside you. For years, I've prayed for a better world. And where we sit today, I realize that our efforts have been shaping that very world. And now we are standing at the threshold of everything we've actually worked for. So I want to encourage you to forge forward with bold confidence. There's a quote by Benjamin Disraeli, who was the former Prime Minister of the UK. And he says that there is no education like adversity. There is no education like adversity. And I want to tell you that the world for once is actually bending towards us. For decades, centuries, women, people of color, immigrants, members of the LGBTQIA communities have felt like our concerns were falling on deaf ears, screaming into the void, not being heard, understood, or invited to the table. But if you open your window, if you're living in a big city, if you turn on the news or scroll social media, it is obvious that the change is imminent and everyone is listening. So I want to encourage you, my Girl Up community, please do not get distracted, dismayed, or discouraged by what you see. Trust what you know and accept what we don't know. Because I want to let you guys in on a really big secret. We never knew. No one ever had all the answers, and no one ever will. But I do know that the key to creating a world that is safe and healthy and prosperous for all of us, that key exists in the girls that are here. And so the things I want you to take away and to walk away with are to first acknowledge the disappointment, acknowledge that this is a very difficult moment. But then I also want you to follow that acknowledgement with the possibility that this uncertainty is a gift. And to think of it more like a package that's being unwrapped than a dark room that's going to swallow you up. I've been seeing a lot of things on social media that say silence is violence, and I'm going to boldly disagree. Trees grow in silence. Thoughts are formed in silence. We are not silent. This community is not silent, and it has never been. We are thoughtful, we are committed, and we understand that this work takes time and it's a process, but we do have those skills. And so I want to encourage you to look at this uncertain moment as a moment where the veil has just come down and we are just stepping into the truth that has already always existed. The second thing is to trust that the work that you've put in still matters and is valid, even if it's put on hold or if it's different than what you thought it would look like. I'm turning 40 in 2020, and standing in this moment, I realize how much of my life looks so different than I ever expected it. And through every disappointment and every door that was closed and that I didn't get to walk through the way that I thought, it led me to something so much greater than anything I could have ever imagined. And that is not just my wish for you, that is my plea to the universe on your behalf, that you are met with grace and opportunity that is unprecedented, just like these unprecedented times. The next thing I'd like to say is to breathe and to take care of yourself. That to prioritize your self-care and mental health at this time is more crucial than ever. The only reason why we even had to have a self-care movement is because we got so far away from ourselves. Do not replace your advocacy with your own homework. Do not advocate for other people instead of advocating for yourselves. This is a time to trust the work, trust the community, and trust all of us collectively to be able to move forward. And the last thing that I will say is to believe in your limitless, world-changing potential now more than ever. Because if anyone on the planet has the skills, the compassion, and the wherewithal to lead us, I am confident that it is you. And I'm so honored to continue to be your champion. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Monique, for those inspiring words. And I agree, we all need to move forward with trust and be comfortable with the uncertainty at this time. Across the country and around the world, we're seeing our Girl Up Club leaders stepping up to organize and mobilize their communities alongside Black Lives Matter. We're seeing clubs organizing and attending protests, calling and writing elected officials, signing petitions, and raising funds for bail funds. We're so proud of all of the ways that clubs are stepping up and organizing for more justice and more peace in their communities during this time. I'm so thrilled to introduce Rebecca Fairweather, our Girl Up Teen Advisor and co-chair for the 2019 and 2020 Teen Advisor cohort. Rebecca, over to you.
Hello, everyone. Congratulations. We did it, kind of. Now, this is not what I had expected at all for my graduation ceremony. But if I'm being honest, I kind of like it more. We don't have to sweat in our cap and gowns. We don't have to spend money on outfits that no one's even going to see anyways. And we don't have to sit through the longest speeches ever. Our generation is so unique that our graduation needed to be the first of its kind. But seeing as this is a graduation ceremony, I have to do the stereotypical thing and tell you a little bit about myself. Now, you may have seen me on the Girl Up Instagram a couple of times, but I do have a life outside of it. I was born and raised in Queens, New York, by two lovely parents who taught me from the get-go, if you want something, work hard for it, and once you get it, never let it go. And I have stood by that statement my entire life, but I've also learned to expand past it. If you want something, work hard for it. Once you get it, never let it go, but also be willing to share your stage with others. I would have never learned that if it weren't for advocacy. My relationship with activism has not been this perfect road. I was entering high school with a gloomy cloud over my head. I had just come out of a deep depression and was still facing issues with anxiety. And joining a school overflowing with 4,000 students was not helping my nerves. Like many freshmen in their beginning days of high school, I was having an identity crisis. There were so many clubs and classes, but one stuck out the most. As you can probably guess, it was Girl Up. I expected a club of a maximum of 10 people, and to my horror, I was deeply mistaken. 100 students squeezed into a non-air-conditioned classroom to talk about gender equality and equity and the importance of investing in a girl. I was absolutely terrified, and I wanted to stand out and speak out, but how was I gonna do that with 99 other people trying to do the same? But as the incredible Lady Gaga said, 100 people can be in a room, and 99 don't believe in you, and just one does. And that was my incredible advisor, Mrs. Simonetti. She taught me to reach for the stars, and that's exactly what I did. I fell in love with the work and began to realize that adolescent girls in developing nations do not have the same opportunities I do. And I was going to do everything in my power to contribute to a cause where community impact actually changes lives. Whether it would be hosting a local fundraiser at my school to deliver bikes to Guatemala, or being on stage with fellow activists to deliver a message of equality, I needed to jump outside of my comfort zone. I became so invested in our message that I continued my journey and applied for the Girl Up Teen Advisor program. I remember getting that acceptance letter and crying my eyes out in the middle of an English class. I was officially in the process of helping others pursue their dreams, and yet I still felt like an imposter. The other teen advisors dedicated their time and effort because they're passionate about the issues, and their resumes reflected their intelligence and their excellence. My resume had some things I was proud of, but nothing that could compare. I felt like I didn't belong. I was a good student, and I cared so deeply for the girls that we were impacting, but was I the right face to represent them when I didn't have the experience? And this is a question that you will ask yourself a lot in your activism journey. But you have to know in your heart that the work that you are doing has an impact, and we are changing the future. Our generation has been loud with what we want. We tend to be impatient when our work doesn't show progress right away. We see that in many forms, like our skincare routines, how quickly we respond to texts, our on-the-go coffee orders, two-day shipping from Amazon, but most importantly, how quickly we want change. This is my favorite quality of this generation, and we cannot slow down anytime soon. We have to keep the steam going and continue to demand change now. This will be draining, make no mistake. The burnout is real. But I am telling you right now, to all of your virtual faces, that you have a community to help you through your challenges and the challenges of the world. You will sit back and think that your actions are minuscule and we are making no impact, but that is not true. Though they are still young, we are paving the way and inspiring future generations to be unafraid to be loud, be consistent with their demands, do not sway for anyone, stand your ground, demand change now. But our actions don't just affect the future, but they are actively affecting the present. This has been especially prevalent in recent protests. We demanded action, and we are achieving change faster than generations before us. We are living in a crazy year, but it has opened many eyes to injustice and oppression happening in our own backyard. We lived through an impeachment, a wildfire, the death of a superstar and his daughter, a historic presidential campaign, a Korean film winning an Oscar, Latinos taking over the Super Bowl, coronavirus, murder hornets, and worldwide outrage of senseless killings of unarmed Black human beings. And it's only been 6 months. We've shown our strength and power in previous years, but 2020 definitely takes the cake. This is a generation who is scared of asking for extra napkins at a restaurant, but will not hesitate to dismantle a corrupt system. The time for change is now, and there is no stopping us. We are powerful. We are the change makers. We are now, and we are the future. Class of 2020, we may be scared for what the future awaits, but if we make the right choices, and we will, there is a future that I am excited to be a part of, and I know you are too. That is why we celebrate today. We've got this in the bag, and I know we're going places even if people don't want us there. We are powerful. You are powerful. Know that. Honor that. Class of 2020, we did it. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Rebecca. Your leadership continues to inspire all of Girl Up and your peers, and you are so right. You all have it in the bag. You have already proven that, and we are so excited to see what you all build this world to be. For those of you entering the next stage of your education on a college campus, know that you can continue with Girl Up. We have 312 campus clubs around the globe who build safe spaces in their community. If your campus does not already have a campus club, you can start one. Check out the Girl Up Clubs and campus page on girlup.org to find out more. Many of you have begun your summer break. If you're looking for a productive way to spend your time, check out our Girl Up YouTube page with our Girl Talk series posted. You can learn from STEM experts how to pursue a successful career in science, technology, engineering, and math, or improve your storytelling skills with our very own Girl Up experts. Now, to a leader who needs no introduction, her many years as a public servant, and most recently, the first Black woman to be elected to Congress from Massachusetts, speaks for herself. Representative Ayanna Pressley.
Hello, Girl Up graduates. Congresswoman Ayanna Pressley here to wish you a very big congratulations on this momentous occasion. Now, last year, I had the honor of addressing many of you at the Girl Up Summit in Washington, D.C., and I was so struck, although not surprised, by the brilliance, the confidence, the joy, and the sisterhood that was on full display that day. Each of you are present leaders, you are future leaders and change agents, and I can't wait to see how you'll apply all that you've learned from Girl Up and the impact that you'll go on to make in our world. Now, you're finishing this program at a time of great consequence for our nation, unprecedented times, tough times, but history has shown us that this is when the best in people is really revealed. This is when our greatest innovations and brilliance are yielded. I can't wait to see all that you will go on to do and to accomplish. I'm so proud of you, and I wish each of you the best of luck in your journey. Congratulations, graduates. Girl up.
Thank you so much, Congresswoman Pressley. So fantastic to hear your inspiring words. And we're so thankful that you could join us at the graduation this year and previously our leadership summit last year. For those of you who attended last year's leadership summit, you might remember Congresswoman's remarks at last year's summit. We're so thankful to continue to have your support. We're looking forward to seeing so many powerful speakers like her on July 13th through 15th for our virtual 2020 Girl Up Leadership Summit. So stay tuned on our website for registration. And with that, I'm so excited to introduce Aparna Nancherla for a short performance. As for those of you who don't know, Aparna is a American comedian and actress. We are so happy that she could join us today. Over to you.
My name is Aparna Nancherla, and I just wanted to wish you a huge congratulations on being the visionaries for tomorrow and the new leaders of today. No big deal. And we are desperately in need of better ways in the world right now, and I know you have them, so no pressure, but we're ready for your ideas whenever you want. Let them roll. And I just wanted to gently remind you, as a woman, sometimes I have trouble saying no to other people when they ask things of me because I don't want to let them down. But I am great when other people tell me no, that they don't want my ideas. So I just wanted to give you permission to say no to other people when you don't feel like what they're asking is in line with your needs or intuition, and to take those no's from other people and turn them into inspiration for future yeses. And, you know, if nothing else, it's just fun to say no once you start saying it. No. 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 See? It's addictive. But I just wanted to wish you, again, a huge congrats. I just feel better knowing you're out in the world and ready to make this earth a better place. So congratulations again and all the best.
Thank you so much, Aparna. That was such a great message to the girls to turn no into yeses and to just have that permission to say no to other people. And I know a couple of girls who have taken that message to heart, and that's actually our outgoing class of 2019-2020 Girl Up Teen Advisors. They are the 10th class to ever have participated in our Girl Up Leadership Program, and they have done a phenomenal job. They have raised funds for UN programs. They have stood up to combat against gender-based violence, and they continue to take action even during these times. I've seen a lot of our teen advisors and even Girl Up clubs hosting Zoom meetings with their club members to really tackle on issues, like most recently, really to combat the gender inequalities within sports, which is, I know it's something that a lot of our Girl Up clubs and all of you listening out there are really passionate about. So I just want to share, thank you all so much for doing that. And if you are still willing and have that energy to be an advocate, we do actually have our petition still up to bring gender equality to the 2021 Summer Olympics. And I know you have all taken action already, so I encourage you all to continue being that advocate by going to girlup.org/sports. But on that note, tomorrow we do have exciting news on the note of leaders and teen advisors. We will actually be announcing our 11th class of Girl Up Teen Advisors, which is incredible because they are by far the largest class we will have, and they represent so many voices across the globe. We have countries like Australia, Brazil, India, Colombia, among many others, and we're so excited to welcome them tomorrow. So I hope you all stay tuned on our social media for that. And on that note, we're so thankful again for everybody just tuning in, but at this time, let's continue the program. And on my way to introduce now is Ingrid Andress, who has a special performance for all of you.
What is up, Girl Up Club members? Congratulations on your graduation. I am so excited to be here to celebrate with you and to honor all the amazing things you've done to fight for equality. It truly is making the world a better place. And I know based on your involvement in this organization that you are also committed to change, and that is so important. Keep up the commitment to change, because you are the future and it is making these dark times seem a little brighter for me. So without further ado, I'm going to play you my song Ladylike. I drink tequila straight, haven't brushed my hair in days, and I'll kiss on the first date if I'm really feeling it. I don't even own a dress, bite my nails when I get stressed, do whatever for attention if I'm needing it. Controversial, so outspoken, I've been told I but I'm a lady like, whoa, I could bring you to your knees and get you kicked out the Garden of Eden. Untamable, unframable, Mona Lisa, oh. Kiss you like a whiskey fire, turn around, leave your heart in a riot. Lipstick and a cigarette pack on the dash, I'm a lady like that. Sometimes I forget not to talk about politics when I'm in the middle of me getting hit on.
but I'm a lady like, whoa, I could bring you to your knees and get you kicked out the Garden of Eden. Untamable, unframable, Mona Lisa, oh, kiss you like a whiskey fire, turn around, leave your heart in a fire, lipstick and a cigarette pack on the dash, I'm a lady like.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you for that performance, Ingrid. Now we welcome to the platform a woman we all deeply admire, Jayathma Wickramanayake, the United Nations Secretary General's Envoy on Youth, a favorite speaker from our 2018 Girl Up Leadership Summit. And we are honored to have her return to congratulate the class of 2020.
Thank you so much. Congratulations to the 2020 class of young change makers. Thank you so much, Girl Up, for including me in these celebrations on this very special day. You guys have worked so hard to get here, and all your hard work is paid off. And now is the time to celebrate your achievements. So as the previous speakers mentioned, please make sure that you take time amidst of all this chaos to celebrate and to appreciate your achievements. I know that this is a celebration that comes at a time of so many challenges. So even though you are celebrating differently to the norms of what a graduation ceremony should look like, I hope this unique once in a lifetime of a generation experience gives you perspective about what's going on in the world around us and how you can utilize your knowledge, skills, and experience to be a part of the change that is making waves around the globe as we speak. We are experiencing a global pandemic, among many other things. COVID-19 has swept through our world, leaving everyday life as we know it at a standstill. Drastic measures have been taken to protect people and prevent the spread of the virus. Large-scale lockdowns, school closures, social distancing, self-isolation, quarantine, travel restrictions, just to name a few, are severely impacting our lives to an extent where we have never seen before. Not to mention the many people who have lost their loved ones over the past months. On top of this unprecedented crisis, we are experiencing a large-scale unrest out on our streets, especially here in the United States and around the world. Demands for systemic change are echoing through our cities, and waves of citizen-led protests are being mobilized on social media. Centuries of racial injustice and abuse of power is being challenged, rightfully so. Everywhere I look, I see young people resisting, protesting, innovating, campaigning, claiming their place. Shouting from behind creative banners with slogans of change, we have had enough. We want to be treated with dignity by systems that represent the voice of the people. We see a different way. To me, there is a straight line from the work that youth organizations like Girl Up doing in the communities to youth-led demonstrations, say for Fridays for Future for Climate, the youth-led democratic revolution we saw in Sudan, March for Our Lives here in the United States, Time's Up for Gender Equality, to what we are witnessing right now through Black Lives Matter. What does this tell us? It tells us that young people like you acknowledge and understand the intersecting nature of the biggest issues of our time. If climate change doesn't stop, people will continue to starve. If conflicts aren't peacefully resolved, there will be no gender equality. If young people aren't included in decision-making, we will not find the right solutions for the future. It also tells us about the power of youth, that young people are a force to be reckoned with. It is time to dispel the myths surrounding young people, that our generation is irresponsible, we are full of troublemakers, that we don't have the capacity and the capabilities to create impact. The idea that young people are change makers is not just a marketing campaign. It is a fact, and you are living evidence that proves that fact. So, my dear graduates, as the United Nations Envoy on Youth, I have the privilege of experiencing firsthand how young people, especially young women and girls like you, are leading the way to achieve a sustainable, peaceful, gender equal world. What I have observed over and over again is that young women and girls are the most vulnerable in society, but often they're also the most resilient and most resourceful in times of crisis. I am talking about girls and young women like you graduating today who are changing the world through activism, one person, one school, one university, one community, and one country at a time. For example, during the COVID-19 pandemic, young people have gone door to door, leading hand washing campaigns, being active in the response as health personnels, countered misinformation and fake news online. Similarly, the Girl Up clubs have shown the way by making masks to keep people safe while practicing social distancing, fundraising to include menstrual products in emergency kits distributed by lower income communities, helping set up e-learning platforms to help students stay up to date with classwork during lockdowns. Some of these solutions, politicians and policymakers wouldn't even have thought of. So young people like you, all over the world, are making a difference by tackling the issues that matter most to them. They are using their voice, energy, and disruptive thinking to push for transformational change. But one thing I know, we will only bring about this change if we work together, closely in solidarity. Our world is currently home to the largest population of young people in history. Approximately half of the world's population is under 30 years. Millennials and Gen Z combined are the largest, the most educated, and the most interconnected generations ever. We also have a tool in front of us that generations before us did not have: technology. Internet, social media platform, with all their flaws, can also be used as great ways to connect, to learn, to advocate, and to organize ourselves. So if we mobilize our sheer numbers, using a technology as a tool to connect, looking past our differences and coming together for a common cause for an equitable, just, fair, peaceful, and sustainable world, no one will be able to stop us. So, dear class of 2020, you are only at the beginning of your journey of being equality advocates and activists, creating change for girls everywhere, but your activism is more needed than ever. Now is the time to stand up against injustice and inequality. While we have seen incremental change over the past decades, evidence shows that we're still 200 years away from closing the gender gap at this current pace. This is unacceptable. So let us take to the streets, build movements, occupy spaces. Those of us who can vote, let's run for political office and make our voices heard. Because as Girl Up's motto says, when girls rise, we all rise. Thank you so much and congratulations once again.
Thank you so much. It is always so fantastic to hear your inspiring perspective on how youth are affecting change all around the world. We are so thankful for your leadership and for your perspective and how you can connect us to the greater movement of youth. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce our Executive Director, Melissa Kilby.
Congratulations, Girl Up graduates. This is truly a moment of celebration. And on behalf of Girl Up, we celebrate each of you. Your passion, your heart, your activism, your voices. You have already answered a call to do right, to fight, to demand equality and justice. You've already joined this work, whether you joined your Girl Up Club, started your Girl Up Club, maybe you met us last week, or you've been a teen advisor over these last few years. As Congresswoman Pressley said, you truly are the bright spot of today. The last couple months have been, as Rebecca put it, one for the record books, and we're only halfway through the year. There have been dark times. There have been lonely times as we've all been at home. Very uncertain and certainly raw, lots of pain. And you're all looking at an uncertain fall. You know, will you have that job waiting for you? What will college look like as you get started? But you've already turned to darkness that you've seen in the world. You took it upon yourselves as students, as young people, to look deeper, to see the real stories, and to bring your light into those dark corners. Please don't stop now. As high school ends or college chapters close, each of these experiences are one step in a lifelong journey. And that step might be ending, but you're also getting ready for an important next one. My advice to you in this moment, embrace learning. Leadership is a journey. The day that you stop learning is the day you should step aside from leadership. And in my experience, the greatest lessons lead to the greatest growth. And how we learn can come in lots of different forms. As I have led Girl Up, and as I've led, you know, teams and work prior to this, where I have learned the most is by listening. Listen especially when you don't like what you hear. That's a good sign that you need to not respond or answer, but you need to hear and feel and absorb. Listen to understand. Listen to empathize. The greatest leaders don't listen for their response. They listen to learn. And I want to say, when you look for the people to listen to, seek out perspectives that will challenge you, give you that constructive feedback, hold you accountable. Relish those voices. Sometimes they're hard to come by. Sometimes it's scary to speak your truth to a leader, but be a leader that takes that, that listens, that creates a space for trust, and trust the voices that are brave enough to speak to you as a leader. My path to leadership has been laid by learning what I didn't know, listening to people who could make me better, smarter, more understanding, more passionate. Monique already shared with us, we don't know what we're doing. We're going on gut, we're going on experience, and we're going and leading and deciding based on the people that we surround ourselves and help us make those decisions. I learn something every day. You will make mistakes. Ask my team, I promise you, it's real. But what you learn from those mistakes are the most important. Those hard lessons are where you step up and become a greater leader, or you fall back into your own insecurities. You will have missteps, you will make mistakes, but don't be afraid to learn. The harder the lesson, the greater the growth. Learning is hard, really listening is harder, but leadership isn't supposed to be easy. Otherwise, everyone would be doing it. You are special, and you already know all of this. My call to you, each of you, Girl Up graduates, is to be the leader that you want to see in this world. You already know how to do it, and you already know a better way. Girl Up will be here with you in each step of that journey. Whether you are graduating and going on a campus, or you are stepping out into the real world, once you are a part of Girl Up, you are always with us. And your journey really truly has just begun. We stand up, we speak up, and we sure as hell rise up. We are with you, we congratulate you, and we wish you the best of luck because we need you. Thank you. And now I'd like to invite our MCs back out to join me for a final message to all of you graduates.
Thank you so much, Melissa, for those words on leadership. And I want to say that all that you need to be a great leader is already inside of you. And we are so excited for each of you to go on and take over the world. So welcoming back all of our incredible guest speakers to the platform. Woo! Congrats, class of 2020.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much, everyone who joined today. Special shout out to Rebecca Fairweather for speaking from your heart and speaking to your peers. You truly are an incredible leader, and we know that each one of you who have led your Girl Up Clubs with such compassion and such passion for the work has, you know, learned from Rebecca and learned from each other. So congratulations, class of 2020, again.
Congratulations. So proud of you.
You did it.
It's 2020. Take my hand and dance with me. We're coming out stronger. We got love, you got me, I got you. We did it, yeah, we did it. Made a couple mistakes, yeah, we'll admit it. But we learned a lot and we pushed it to the limit. Wouldn't have it any other way, no different. We did it. Yeah, we did it. Took more than a second, more than a minute. But we learned a lot and we pushed it to the limit. Guess you could say we got 2020 vision. Here's to 2020. Take my hand and dance with me. Yeah, we did it. Took a wrong turn, but at least we finished. Took a few L's, but we came out winning. Let them all know we got big ambition. We did it, yeah, we did it. Best is ahead, and you know we'll get it. Got a lot of dreams, there's no way we're quitting. Guess you can say we got 2020 vision.
Here's to 2020. Take my hand and dance with me.